Status Quo and Down Down, number one on the charts back in December of 1974. And let's stay in that same year, but wind back to the 25th of May, 40 years ago today, when Rick Wakeman became the first member of Yes to top the charts with his album Journey to the Center of the Earth. As the cost of recording the album in a studio was too high, it was recorded live in concert with the London Symphony Orchestra at the Royal Albert Hall. Later on in 1977, Rick spoke to Bob Kilby at Radio 1 about reforming with Yes after 3 years and his new solo project called Criminal Record. With music from Journey to the Center of the Earth, this is our mix telling the story of Rick Wakeman in the 70s.
Yes, we're in Switzerland, rehearsing for doing the album. Alex Scott called me into the office up at San Artis and said that Pat was leaving the band and would I like to go over there and do some work on the album. So I said I would be very interested, but only on a sort of a session basis. And I'd spoken to John Anderson on the phone and they'd knocked up a couple of quick demos between the four of them of a couple of the songs, Going for the One and part of Turn of the Century. I heard the rough tapes and it was amazing, it just didn't sound, it wasn't Yes, it was like Back to Fragile Days, the music that I felt that I could offer something to. It was very strange, it wasn't like I'd been out for 3 years. Then the following night there was a party at Claude Nobbs's house, who's the head of WEA in Switzerland. And we were all sitting round and I think it was Chris who sort of said, well, we've got a tour coming up at the end of the album, which sort of, you know, I said, yeah, sounds great. And they said, well, then we're doing another album, I should think, after a European tour. So, yeah, I said, well, might as well, would you fancy, I said, that sounds great to me. And Brian Lane, our wondrous manager, said, just as well, because I told Melody Maker yesterday.
Well, in the time you've been away from Yes, Rick, everybody in the band has done their own solo project. Now, I think that can probably work in two different ways. Either somebody will have a successful solo project and then decide that they don't really want to get back with the band, or else they'll get it out of their system and things will be a lot fresher when they get back. Which do you think will prevail with Yes?
The interesting thing was when they did their solo projects, I mean, I was very worried because I thought, well, I wondered what effect it would have when the band got back together again. Whether it would unite them or whether it would split the band up even further. I found when I went back in November, it had absolutely reinforced the band because everybody got their frustrations out. Everybody found out the things that they sort of did best. And on this album, when I went over there, everybody wanted to offer the things that they did best, you know, to Yes.
What about the Rick Wakeman fans who are sitting back and saying, well, this is all very fine, Yes, reborn, but how about your own solo projects? What are your plans there?
Well, when we finished the Yes album, which was on the end of April, I started on mine on May the 1st, and I finished it 2 days ago. The album is a keyboard album, and there's 20 seconds of vocal. Just 20 seconds from, would you believe, Bilotti.
Not really.
It's true. There's 20 seconds of vocal from Bilotti. It was fantastic. He came over and did one track.